Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's your host, Dr. Giggles, in the house. So this week's show is just mainly strictly Wicked Cyclone. So we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about Media Day. I decided to throw a contest. I got some cool prizes that I'm going to give away. We got some cool things to give away. And, oh, I can hear myself in the background. Let me tell you, as we all know, we've been all pumped about Wicked Cyclone. So like I was saying, this shows, and if there's a little time, maybe we'll talk about events, but this is all about Wicked Cyclone and Media Day. So if you have questions about anything, that for those that did not go to Media Day, feel free to, what the hell?
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's your host, Dr. Giggles in the house.
Why is it doing that? Okay, well, that's cool. I have no idea. It's going crazy over here. Anyway, so if anybody has any questions, concerns about Wicked Cyclone or anything, I do have some tips and tricks and some concerns, especially for bigger people and stuff like that, how to get on, because there were some big people that didn't get to ride but came back and rode. So I will give you some tips and tricks and stuff like that on what these people did, including myself. I'll go through the whole rundown and all that. But anyway, as we all know, we've been talking about this ever since the rumor came about. Last April, roughly, was the rumor flying around. You know, all the markings and people seeing things and seeing the RMC trucks and stuff like that. And until we got the announcement. So everything built up to yesterday. Everything was a giant build-up. So we got to yesterday, and then after we rode yesterday, it was like, it was just one of those things. Now, let's get into, the start of the day. Now, I had to be at the park for 5 a.m., so what I did was I went to bed at 3 o'clock in the afternoon on Tuesday, woke up at 10:30 at night. I had my alarm set for 11:15, every 15 minutes all the way up to 1 o'clock in the morning to make sure I didn't miss it. Because usually if I go to bed late or something, I've almost missed airplanes and stuff like that. So that's what I did. And I was in the parking lot by 4:30, and then, we got there. I had interviews set up starting at 5:20. Things got off a little late start, as it was early in the morning, them doing their thing with the ride. But let me tell you, I didn't get my first ride till about 5:30, 5:45 in the morning, around there. I did an interview with Pete Carmichael, which is the director of operations of the park. I've known him, for a few years now, so it was great to do the interview with him. And basically the video that it's like a 12-minute video that I put together, I'll show later on. It's got a mixture of interviews and, tons of video and some pictures, but mainly video. It's going to have my reverse POV on it. It's going to have a little bit of everything about the ride and all that. And I'm just going to run down Media Day, how it went, and then at the end of that, I will tell you what was great, what was bad, I will tell you all about the ride, and then any questions that you have about it, feel free to ask. Yeah, you beat me in there probably by a couple minutes. You probably did. You probably did beat me by a couple minutes. But anyway, so, even in the parking lot at 4:30 in the morning, everybody was amped up. It was chilly, don't get me wrong. It was cold, and I was probably at the time the only idiot in a t-shirt and shorts. Well, not a t-shirt, but a polo short sleeve shirt thing. I'm talking to everybody, and, people are coming in, and everybody's chit-chatting and loving it, everybody's loving it up, and, there were certain people that got to get First Rider shirts. I wasn't one of them, unfortunately. It was only for those that were doing interviews for TV, got First Rider t-shirts. All in all, there was, 30 aces. There was myself, AJ, Zach. There was local TV media, a couple of Coaster Crew guys and Amusement Wire guys, and then personnel and all that. That was basically, that was there at 5 o'clock in the morning. There was nobody else at five. I know Coaster Crew people showed up a little bit later, but like around 6:30-ish, 6:30, something like that. But yeah, that was basically it for 5 o'clock in the morning. They kept it very limited. And one thing that I made sure I did was I brought my laptop, as you guys saw early in the morning. I brought my laptop. I plugged in the USB. I used my cell phone as a hotspot, and it worked really well, really fast. And I didn't edit the video. I just put it straight up on YouTube for everybody to see, which was great. Yeah, you know what? I don't know if you had this problem, but when I pulled up to the security guard, he's looking at a list of names. My name wasn't on that list. So he radioed in to whoever, and then they were like, 10-4. So I was all good to come in. So I came in. I checked in with one of the girls, and then another girl took me down there with some other people, the interview people, and we walked down to the ride. And, you know, the excitement started growing more and more the closer I got to this ride, you know, because everybody's been waiting for this day. Everybody wanted to see this happen. Everybody wanted to ride it. And, I mean, I know between myself, Zach, and AJ, we really couldn't contain our excitement to ride this ride. Well, Don, you were part of you were part of the Ace crew that got left behind. But I'm talking media-wise that was there, and Acers, and, you know, stuff like that. You were part of the Ace crew. Usually, I'm part of the Ace crew. This felt weird for me because usually I am part of the Ace crew, not doing a media thing as media. So this was the first time I did that. And let me tell you, it was different. It was pretty crazy to experience that and be part of that. Oh, that's what that is. It was just, I don't know. I mean, I know some of you here wrote it. Most of you haven't. But it was just, when you finally got to ride it, it was amazing. And at first, they didn't have the smoke coming out of the plane and the van, and then they did. Were you right behind us? I don't know. I was just there. But then I was doing my interview and kind of got lost in the moment. I started getting lost in this whole moment of, you know, hey, it's going on. It's going down. We're taking pictures and video and interviews. And I made sure, even after I did the interview, I did not do my I did not ride it before the POV. I wanted to capture my first ride on camera. I wanted that first ride. And then after that, then I did another interview, and then, you know, I went and had breakfast. They had an awesome breakfast. But that POV is a legit first experience ride that's not faked, acted, retaked, redone. That was the first time. And a lot of people liked it. Plus, you could see my fat body flailing all around and everybody getting, you know, a lot of people said, hey, that was like the best one that you could really see the forces of how that really is on the POV. I've only watched a few. I know there's a bunch of them out there, but I know I've watched maybe two or three of them of, the people on it. And, you know, I can't even describe. Well, actually I can. If you watched the video and you heard the end, it took my breath away. It literally, my first ride took my breath away. Like, when I got off, I said, what the hell did I just ride? Like, not in a bad way. I was just like, that was a ride that, the type of ride that I've been looking for so long. It gave me everything that I wanted in a coaster. Now, some people love it. Some people are like, eh, it's all right. Some people don't like it. It is what it is. But the buzz on the street is pretty strong about it and pretty crazy. You know, I've been following every, I've been looking at every kind of forum, every amusement park site, this, that, and the, I've been watching everything. I've been reading everything. I felt like a spy. I've been checking what people have been saying. But anyway, it's the kind of ride that I've been looking for a long time. You know, for what I like in a ride, that ride, once you hit that first drop, forget it. Nonstop, crazy, twists, turns, upside downs, banks, flippy, floppy, all this other stuff. It was that kind of crazy. It was that kind of crazy that I loved. I rode it 30 times or more between 5:30 a.m. and 11 a.m. I mean, we probably could have got more rides, but between, you know, all the camera stuff and all that, it slowed it down. Let me tell you, this is something that the park needed. It's definitely the boost that the park needed. It's always going to have its Bizarro, and Bizarro is always going to have a place in my heart. But honestly, I put Wicked Cyclone as my number one steal and move Bizarro to number two. I know that's shocking because I love Bizarro, and I'm always going to love Bizarro, but Bizarro is not as intense and insane as Wicked Cyclone. It's if you haven't ridden it, obviously it's not open yet. You know, starting tomorrow, if you got a season pass, and Saturday, you can ride it. If not, opens to the public on Sunday. And let me tell you, when you do ride it, it's crazy as all hell. It's the ride I've been looking for. It's so smooth. And I have to say, even when you do get stapled in, it doesn't hurt. Like, if I ride El Toro and they staple me in, that hurts. That restraint sucks. You know, the senses are whacked off. They're not working right on El Toro. Whatever the reason is. And, well, you know what? We all want everything. And to me, Wicked Cyclone gives me everything I want. It really gave me everything. I was so happy when I got off that ride. My excitement grew for the ride even more, and I had already ridden it. When I rode it, even getting, I mean, there was rides I got stapled, there was rides I didn't get stapled. Even when I was stapled, it didn't hurt. You know, I could breathe, it was a great ride. I couldn't contain myself. I was excited all day, so happy that I finally rode it. It exceeded my expectations, because, I mean, we've all seen the POV. We saw the off-road videos, you know, the off-ride videos that Six Flags New England put out, and we were like, wow, this thing's great. But once you know what? All those videos, even my video doesn't even do it justice, because you can't feel what I felt, and you can't feel what everybody else felt. I mean, the adrenaline rush, the from going in all the inversions, the hang time, the zero G rolls, all the way that this track twists and turns, and the air time, and the, you know, the double downs and the reverse banks and all that. You know, just going all around like this, and then all of a sudden the train's going left and you're going right. It's an intense ride. It's crazy. I mean, I've been showing this video to people that aren't coaster enthusiasts. So, you know, they go to the park once in a while and they're like, wow, I want to ride that. A quick story. Matter of fact, yesterday I stopped at the convenience store near my house. While I'm in there, I bumped into a guy that I met at Dunkin' Donuts near my house. Him and his wife were going to Six Flags on opening day. Well, I saw the husband again. And I talk to the clerk all the time. And he's like, hey, how was your day? And I said, hey, I just came back from Six Flags. I rode the new ride. It was media day, blah, blah, blah. And then the guy goes, oh, I'm going Saturday just for that. And I showed him the reverse POV video. And he was going nuts. He's like, oh, my God, that looks awesome. And then he's like, I can't wait to go home and tell my wife. And he was all kinds of, you know, all kinds of excited. So, you know what? I will have to say that El Toro's restraints suck. I will take Bizarro's restraints any day over El Toro's. See, when I ride Bizarro, I am comfortable in that restraint. I'm short. It doesn't bother my legs like you tall guys. Bizarro doesn't hurt my stomach. You know, I got. I'm working on getting rid of it, and it's slowly going down. Slowly going down. That's my fault for being fat and eating all that other crazy stuff. That's my fault. You know, El Toro is an awesome ride. I still ride it even though I can't breathe for the whole ride length of the ride. But that restraint sucks. I don't care what anybody says. It's the worst restraint. I know somebody like Luco loves, you know, El Toro versus Bizarro because he's tall. So El Toro fits him nice and Bizarro doesn't fit him. So, I don't know, man. It was those restraints are night and day. I will take... I mean, I don't know about you, but I definitely can say it's better than Bizarro. I know you people will probably go, you're nuts, you're nuts, you're nuts. But I'm telling you, it's... Wicked Cyclone is the coaster that gives me everything I want. Non-stop action, inversions, all kinds of elements. You know, it gives me everything I want. And the funny thing is, it's not the tallest, and it surely isn't the fastest, but it gives me everything I want. You know? So, I don't know. I mean, I can't wait for all of you guys to finally get your ride on Wicked Cyclone so that you can... I want to hear what every... When you guys ride it, I want to know what everybody... And the guys that wrote it, I know Don did. You know, I want to know... You know, anybody that's watching that has ridden Wicked Cyclone on Media Day, I want you guys in the chat... Tell, you don't have to say what's better than the other, but... I genuinely want to know what you thought about Wicked Cyclone. You don't have to compare it to any ride. Just based off of riding it, what do you think? What do you like about it? What do you hate about it? You know, so it's... That's what I want to know from you guys. But what I'm going to tell you what I love everything about Wicked Cyclone except one thing. And I know that the park is working on this. I don't know if you guys know, the ones that did ride, I don't know if you noticed, you know, they kept calling, there's two cars that really have trouble. It's car two, car four. And it always seems to be row one. On the right-hand side seems to be the one with the issues of people. And I got it like... It happened to me two times. Now, I was in car two, row one, for like 10 times in a row. And I go for the 11th time. And, I mean, they stapled the crap out of me. I mean, if they stapled anymore, I think it would have broke half of my body in half. It was down like a little kid. It was down all the way. You couldn't put it. And you know what was cool? You literally couldn't put it down any further. Like, even if there wasn't a person there... It was down as far as it was going to go, and the sensor was just like, you're too fat, get out of here. But the girl, that one of the ride ops that were checking restraints, told the operator, he's been riding this thing all day. And everybody in the station's like, he's been on it. Like, he just got here. He didn't, like, walk on. So the ride op says, try this one. It was the same row, next seat, left side, and she didn't even staple me. She just said, hey, let's just try it normal, see what happens. Lock, restraint, go. So, it happened to me in car four, row one, right side. Same thing. Now, there was some people that couldn't get on it, that got on it later. Now, from what I was told, what they did, and, you know, they had some big guts. They actually lifted their stomachs up, let them staple down, and then put their stomachs down and rode it. They said they were a little squished, but they got to ride it, and they enjoyed it either way. So, for those that have that issue, lift your stomach up, let the bar come down, and then you should be fine. I know it sounds messed up, but if you want to ride it, that's gonna happen. Or maybe you may have to switch seats. And it's weird. And you know, there's some seats, there's absolutely no problem. I talked to the park about it. They said they have to adjust the sensors. It's, you know, it's part of the whole learning curve, you know, trying to get everything right. So, one, everything's safe. And the reason, and I do know why, why it is noisy. They were having issues with the wheels. One, when they first started it with the regular polyurethane nylon wheels, it was too fast. And what they, you know, and it was also ripping up the paint, and the paint was getting stuck on the wheels, causing some issues. So they changed it to metal wheels, and that's why it's making the noise it is, because they're using it to rip the paint up. So that's what is going on. And then once, that's why you're seeing those the wheel strips on the track, you know, where it's ripping the paint off. They're doing that on purpose. And then the wheels. So it's actually going to get probably a little faster and smoother, if you can believe it or not. All that screeching and stuff's going to go away. You just got to have to give it like a few more weeks. Because the problem is, it hasn't been enough warm days. You know, think about it. This coaster hasn't really been warmed up for the season. And it's never been warmed up. This is the first season. And the ride is running, even though with the issue it's running with right now, it is running fantastic. It is running amazing, regardless of that. I mean, there's going to be hiccups. It's a brand new ride. There's always issues with rides. We all know this. It made the ride time slow because of the cameras and stuff like that. You know, changing cameras, batteries, doing this, doing that, taking the rig off and all that. So... yeah, and I'm hearing about Twisted Colossus, and I'm hearing mixed reviews on it. I'm holding my own judgment till I ride it, but I'm hearing the mixed reviews. Some people say it's awesome. Some people say it sucks. I don't know. I would love to ride it myself. I mean, it looks cool from what it does, but I don't know. Well, I'll find out probably like in 2 years when I go. But anyway, back to Wicked Cyclone. The cool thing was, what's his name? Alan, I keep messing up his last name. Shilkey, I want to say is his last name, I think. I apologize, I keep getting his last name wrong all the time, but I talked to him for a while. You know, you get to ride with him, you get to talk to him, you get to... you know, the guy is really, you know, he reminds me of like a hippie, but a cool guy and very down to earth. A lot of people didn't know who he was, but that guy is the guy who designed Wicked Cyclone from Rocky Mountain Coasters. He came on down, he was watching, he was excited. Yeah, Shilkey, something like that. And let me tell you, that guy is one cool dude. You know, I took a picture with him. He actually jumped in the Ace New England group photo. He jumped in that. It was cool. We were like, hey, come on over. You know, we got him in there. And then he's like, do you mind? We're like, nah, get in. The whole experience was cool. Now, one thing, I don't know if people knew this. There was two different color badges. One orange, one blue. Orange was for media. Blue was for coaster enthusiasts. Bloggers, blah, 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 you know, stuff like that. I didn't get a badge, but, I ended up eating at Captain Rivy's. That's where, I had a cheeseburger. But I could have eaten at Take Six, and I probably should have, because that's where the better food was. They had all kinds of crazy food. All different kinds of meats and macaroni and cheese and... all kinds of crap. I didn't eat any of it. I didn't want to eat too much. I wasn't really hungry. I just wanted to ride the ride. There was free ice cream from Friendly's. There was It was like little Sunday cups you could get. They had, and if you were in the media, you had open bar. So that's where the open bar was. So some people that I talked to were upset about the Captain Rivy food, especially when they found out about the other food, that they would have rather had the other food. So some people were upset about that. To me, it really didn't matter. I wasn't there for food. And everybody knows me. I'm not one for crazy fancy food. So I was happy with the cheeseburger. You know, it's the same cheeseburger I get every time. You could have had pizza or chicken fingers. I ate a cheeseburger. I'm not mad about the food. I mean, like I said, I could have eaten... I mean, I couldn't get any alcohol because I didn't have the badge. But I could have eaten the food. Because when I got the email told me, take six. So that's what that was. So for those that were wondering where the good food was, it was over by, it was at Take Six. That's where all the good food was. So inside they had, you know, they had two different kinds of goodie bags. They had the bag, the drawstring bag. Some had Cyclone wood in it. The one that I got was, it had a little Six Flags cup. It had a Wicked Cyclone pin. It had a pencil, like the one I broke. I have two pencils now, but it was one of these, rest its soul, but now I have two of them. But yeah, it had one of those. It had some candy in it. And, oh, a coupon for a free ice cream beverage from Friendly's. I know, oh yeah, the one with the wood had a Friendly's Frisbee and some candy and some other stuff. I don't know. There's pictures of that. Well, it was the wood like they gave out at Norista with the stamp on it. They gave that wood out. That's the, you know, that was the wood that they had given out in the bag. So that's what they did with that. What else am I forgetting? Oh, they had the ribbon cutting. They had Reed Timmer from Storm Chasers there. You know, he talked, he was doing the ride and on-ride interviews and stuff like that with TV and stuff like that. The ribbon cutting ceremony was cool because on the infield, in the queue area, they'd let you sit on the rocks and stuff and stand on the rocks and watch. And let me tell you, it was short and sweet. Usually, when you go to these things, they go on and on for like 30 minutes and everybody's kissing each other's butt and thanks for coming and, oh, this is big for the town. I mean, I understand why they do it. You know, one hand greases the other. Everybody's happy. They brought tax dollars in. Tourism dollars come in and so on. I get it, man. I get it. But this one was like 14 minutes long. It was probably the shortest ribbon cutting official opening ceremony I've ever been to. And it was awesome. They even had like a little skit thing that I put in the video. It was cool. Yeah, Larry, if you're looking for them, when you're walking through the queue, you're going to see like a big black sign. Look behind, like after you walk by the van and you're walking like to go like this, you're going to see this big Cyclone sign or something, black sign. If you look on it on the wall before you go underneath underneath the lift hill, you're going to see the two boards right there. It was kind of hidden, but it's open. Yeah, if you go to the plane and haven't seen it, you went too far. You have to go back. And the cool thing, you know, like they had, like the theming. Theming was awesome because they ended up with the smoke working on the van. They had the smoke working on the plane. It looked like Cheech and Chong were having fun in the plane and in the van. But they were also putting the logo on the front, you know, the god or the weather god that's on the front of the train. They also had put on the satellite on the side of the buses. They had them on the boat and all that. And there's also a nice Easter egg to Alan Shilkey and William Cobb. And when you're in the queue line, you're looking at the TVs, and they got the whole storm news things going on. You will see. They call them Alan Cobb and William Shilkey. You know, one's a doctor, one's a this and the other, and all that. And let me tell you, it wasn't an actual ribbon cut. It was more of, you know, confetti going off, the ride going up the ride, confetti blows, and then Jen McGrath saying that, hey, the ride's open, you know. So, you know, it was cool. It wasn't didn't actually cut a ribbon. It was more of a confetti cannons going off. That's kind of what, you know, that they did. I got a Frisbee signed by the Rangers mascot. Okay, so, but like I said, the whole thing leading up to everything was great. I'm trying to think. I feel like I'm missing something. I feel like I'm missing something. I don't know why. Oh, yeah. Once the ride opened, I was sitting on the ground, and Clint from In the Loop was like, man, he put his hand out. He's like, you better get up, man. They're going to trample you. Because everybody's getting into the queue line. Now, I had already ridden it 30 times. I didn't care about really riding it anymore. So I went and had lunch. You know, I took off and had lunch. But while I was doing that, I got into the Flash Pass line out of the regular line. And then I'm talking to people as they're, you know, they're in line. And, you know, I saw people and was chit-chatting it up and, you know, and all that. He just threw it to me, so I kept it. Didn't even know him. Who threw what to? The confetti? I don't know what got thrown to you, Adam. I don't know what got thrown to you. But I will say that there was breakfast. I didn't mention that. I thought it was going to be like Danish and coffee kind of thing. It was actually like juice and eggs and sausage and bacon and potatoes. And they did have Danish, and they had muffins, and they had bagels, and like I said, juice and stuff. Six Flags really did go pretty much all out. I mean, it was better than past media days that I've been to. I mean, was it the best media day I've ever been to? No, but it was pretty damn good. I mean, I had fun. It was all about the excitement and the ride. I wasn't really necessarily there for a gift or food. You know, people complained about gifts and food. That was some of the stuff that I heard about complaints that were like, eh. And I'm like, dude, I don't care about the gifts and the food, and I'm not there for that. Even though gifts and food are a nice little add-on touch. You know, that's the extra bonus. But, like I said, to me, it didn't bother me one bit, because I was like, Wicked Cyclone, that's what I'm here for. I'm not here for this, that, and the other. So, you know, I don't know what more I could say about that. I mean, I know a lot of people had fun. A lot of people loved the ride. The excitement was in the air. The people were loving it. It was just a great experience. And matter of fact, tomorrow I'm skipping work. I'm going to the park. And I'm going to get my rides in tomorrow. I'm sure there's going to be a bunch of people there. And I'm sure the queue line's probably going to fill up. And, you know, I got nothing but time. Nothing but time tomorrow. So I'll just ride it however many times I can get on it. You know, no sweat off my back. I'm just going to ride it and have fun. And besides, I'm going to be there all weekend. And I'm going to take a lot of pictures, videos. I want to see how long the line does, in fact, get. you know, on Sunday when the ride opens. Now, for those that don't know and you live under a rock, the height restriction is 48 inches. At the time of media day, the test seat was not out. The space is there for it. It's already allotted for it. They just got to put it out. I don't know if it's out. I know right now, it could be over by now. I don't know. But today was employee night, day, whatever. So I don't know if the test seat is out yet. I'm hoping at least it's out tomorrow or by at least Sunday anyway, because if not, that's going to cause problems. And they really should have people sit in the test seat before they go up, because it's what's going to happen is people are going to get really upset. People are going to get in that ride and they're going to go, crap, I waited however long and I can't ride it. Now you get some angry, you got an angry customer, you got an angry guest. So hopefully that they put that seat out, and if they see a bigger guest, it's better to embarrass them at the test seat than it is at the station in front of everybody. I mean, yes, there's people there, but at least when they were in the test seat and you go, nah, you can't. You can't fit. All right, now you, you know, now you gotta. The worst thing a park can do is make people do the walk of shame. That is the worst thing you can do to a guest. The worst thing. So hopefully they're watching this, and hopefully they hear what I'm saying, because if they do not want to piss people off, you would rather piss them off at the front than make them wait a couple hours and they can't get in. You know, they can't get on it. When they get up there and they're told they can't ride, that is the worst thing they can do. Plus, it cuts the line down because you're already tossing people out. You let them sit in the test seat. If it goes, you let them in. If it doesn't, sorry, can't ride. They can go to customer service and complain there. And then, you know, park does what park does to make that guest happy. So. Yeah, I mean. Oh, all right, so the test seat is out, so that's good. That is good. I haven't seen anything. Oh, yeah, but nobody asked about the single rider line thing. I didn't see a sign for that. I wonder if you can use that. We're going through the fast pass lane. I should email the park that and ask that. I don't know why I never asked that. I didn't even put that in a question. I don't know nothing about it unless they're not doing a single rider line. I don't know. I thought Goliath had a test seat. In Germany, there is a thing if it, in the end, don't touch, you don't ride. Well, you know what? I mean, for me, the ride was always touching and doing what it was supposed to do. It went down. It's supposed to touch your thighs. You know, it's supposed to touch up here, and it always did on me. I didn't have an issue with it. So who the hell knows? I mean, I don't know. Also, as you can see, I'm wearing a Wicked Cyclone t-shirt that I purchased. They have another one. They have... what, two more shirts and a sweatshirt? They're $15.99, fat size like mine, $17.99, 2X and more. But I'm probably almost getting ready to get into an XL because look at how much. I got a lot of room in this shirt where earlier this year itself, you know, before coaster season started, you guys saw how fat I was. The shirt was stretched out, man. My stomach was out here, literally. My stomach shrunk quite a bit. I've lost a few pounds here and there. Yeah, you are right. It does need a test seat. But when you go, Larry, I would have, you know, I know you're worried about if Tina fitting. I would have her sit in the test seat and see if it works. I mean, Larry, you shouldn't miss out on, I mean, I understand you want to ride it with wifey. I understand that. And I wouldn't miss out on it. I mean, I know you have your reasons if you don't ride it, and I respect those reasons, but let me tell you, I'm going to tell every one of you, you need to get down there and at least ride it one time. See, personally, I like Goliath. I love Goliath. And when I take the kid Saturday, I'm going to put Jeremy on Goliath. He needs that credit, and he needs Wicked Cyclone. So we're going to do Wicked Cyclone first, then we're going to go do Goliath. So yeah, it'll be all good. And then, I don't know if everybody knew about the Platinum Flash Pass. Wicked Cyclone's on it. I think I said it, but in case I didn't, just a friendly reminder. Wicked Cyclone is on the Platinum Pass. You don't get double rides, but you click it, you go on, you have to re-click it, get back on. So you don't have to, because I know the way Texas Giant did it was you had to schedule a time at the Flash Pass when you got your Flash Pass, and that was your time to ride. Larry, I give you a lot of credit. See, I'm a jerk, and if my wife couldn't ride it, I'd be like, ride the bench. I'm riding this. You know, I mean, that's just because I'm a jerk. I'm insensitive. That's probably why, I am the way I am. I'm sure in a year or two, Wicked Cyclone will go on the gold pass and the regular pass. You know, so, you know, I may do the Platinum Pass at some point in the summer when it's busy. I may do it, you know, with the kids. Just, you know, I like to do it every once in a blue moon. I haven't gotten a Platinum Pass at New England since the first year it appeared, however many years ago that was. So I'll give it a try. That way I can keep getting a lot of rides on Wicked Cyclone. Then I can get, you know, double rides on other rides. It'll be cool. You know, it'll be cool. I mean, once in a while, I don't mind. You know, I don't mind splurging once in a blue moon. I mean, I used to get flash passes all the time. I was stupid. You know. But yeah, they also, if you're looking for New England Skyscreamer merch, is that the same merch as with the Wicked Cyclone stuff? There's another shirt that's kind of busy like this, and then there's one with just the Wicked Cyclone logo. Just the Wicked Cyclone logo is on the sweatshirt as well. The sweatshirts were like $31, not too bad. Not too bad at all. You know, so it's, like I said, you guys need to get out there and you need to ride it. It's really like, I mean, like I said, it's intense, it's crazy, it took my breath away, it was everything that I wanted. Now anyway, enough of my rambling on, I'm going to put the video on, and then you watch the video, and then if you have any other questions about the ride, or you're just going to come and ride it, hey, that's on you. But let me pull up the video here. Here we go!
This is your local meteorologist, William Schilke, reporting on the latest storm activity. To learn more about its impact, we go live to Agawam, Massachusetts with Wendy Shadler.
Thanks, William. I'm here at the Chase Command Center with the founder of Cyclone Hunters and Storm Enthusiasts, Dr. Alan Cobb. Dr. Cobb, can you tell us what happened here?
As you can see, the storm touched down near our command center. My team of storm chasers went to research the progression of the storm and are in need of more species.
To Western Mass News meteorologist Nick Morganelli. That's right, Dave. Just look at the radar. We've never seen weather like this here in New England before. Spiraling winds, extreme lightning, and wicked severe flooding.
Our storm trackers are sending data we've never even seen before. Let's send it out to Lindsay Idaluca for the latest as folks try to deal with this wicked severe weather. Lindsay.
Yeah, that's right, Nick. Just when we thought Mother Nature was going to give us a break, the system looks like it's making a loop back around. It's hitting us even harder. Be careful, you could get swept up in this wicked cyclone. We've got new information coming out. Western Mass News, First Warning Weather Center, Dan Brown. Dan, what's the latest?
Folks, we told you this was going to be a big one, and I'm getting word that the National Weather Service is now officially calling this a wicked cyclone. That's right, this is a wicked cyclone, a full-blown Category 6. This massive storm continues to strengthen. Stay with us to continue to get real-time data as it comes in. Charisse?
Thanks, Dan. Powerful winds and brutal rain seem to be focused over the Agawam area as we speak. Here's what you need to know as the storm passes over us. Make sure to head to the Storm Chaser Escape to get out of this weather as quickly as you can.
What was your first impression when you heard that Wicked Cyclone was coming to the park?
Well, I'll tell you what, last year we were very, very excited to hear that we were able to put in the East Coast's first hybrid roller coaster, which obviously combines the technology of our old classic New England Cyclone wood coaster with the iBox steel track out here to make it a steel coaster. So we were very excited.
Yeah, we were excited when we heard it as well. I can't even think of it. The next question I have is, did you ride Wicked Cyclone? What did you think about it, and what was your favorite element?
You know what? I was able to ride it earlier, and it was really a fantastic ride. It is nonstop action from the time that you drop over the 78-degree drop to the time that you pull into the station. It is like riding a Bronco. There are 14 airtime hills, which is a record for the East Coast. This coaster actually has more airtime than any other roller coaster on the East.
Wow, that's crazy. So what was your favorite element throughout that?
I would say my personal favorite was our hang time version. That too is the first one that's ever been done. And you flip up into the ride upside down, hang there for a couple of seconds, and then reverse out of the opening.
Marketing an amazing ride like Wicked Cyclone.
It is many years in the working. We've actually been working on this for several years. First thing that we work on is the logo, the naming, the theming, and then the announcement, which generally happens around Labor Day. And then we put together approximately a 120-page marketing plan that's integrated with group sales, public relations, advertising, promotions, which is all within my department, to open up to an event like today.
Wow, that's great.
Once we narrowed down the name, and we picked Cyclone, obviously, because of the original wood structure, and then Wicked, because of being in New England for the meaning of the word wicked. So that's how we picked the name.
And since you wrote it, what was your favorite element out of everything that you've written on this?
I will tell you, my favorite thing it always is the drop down. So the 78-degree drop is my favorite, personally.
I noticed I got the most hang time out of that zero-G roll over there. Easter eggs inside the ride of theming for a throwback to Cyclone.
Well, when we have a plaque that's directly behind this chase up on the side, where at the Northeaster everybody got to sign their name, so that is up against the wall. And then the plane, that is part of the theming. The plane, we numbered the plane after one of our corporate people at our corporate office, because he owns a plane.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Is there anything you'd like to say to the fans of SFNE Online?
Continue being our big supporters. We're so honored to have your passion, support, and your dedication to us. And we're excited to celebrate this wicked season with you.
Hey guys, I'm extreme meteorologist Reed Timmer here in the storm center, and it feels just like the morning before a storm chase right now, I'll tell you that right now. I've chased almost 1,000 tornadoes, several hurts, dozens of hurricanes, Hurricane Katrina, even a blizzard out here in Cape Cod. My first nor'easter this past winter had 77-mile-an-hour winds, crazy whiteout conditions. We've had our windows blown out by softball-sized hail, even just a couple of days ago. On the way up here, we were chasing some mothership supercells into Catskills and followed them into northwest Connecticut, just like it was meant to be. Here, very excited to be here at the Wicked Cyclone, and I'm about to dominate this storm. Never stop chasing.
You are surrounded by a lot of members from the organization ACE, the American Coaster Enthusiasts. The New England chapter, and I think we have many people from other regions as well. And thank you so much for taking the time to be with us.
My little video shindig thingamajiggy wiggy of, you know, different kind of things of Wicked Cyclone. I actually would like to thank Six Flags New England, John Winkler, and Jen McGrath, and Jennifer Mance, and Kyle Kroger, and Rocky Mountain Coasters, and anybody who had anything to do with Wicked Cyclone and the event. They did a great job. The ride's magnificent. I have more excitement for this than I did Fury. When I said about Fury, like I said, I wasn't knocking it. I just said it wasn't the best ride. It was, and we've talked, and I've talked about with people about Fury. I think if Fury was about 10 miles an hour slower, it would be a better ride. I think the speed killed the ride. That's just me. But anyway, this is all about Wicked Cyclone today. So, I really think that the park has a winner. And I think what's going to happen is when it comes to the golden ticket ballot, the battle is going to be between the two new RMCs. It's going to be between Wicked Cyclone and Twisted Colossus. They're going to battle it out, and between those two, those are going to be your number one and two in any incarnation, but I have a feeling that Wicked Cyclone in the end is going to be better than Twisted Colossus. Maybe because I'm biased. Maybe because, if you look at the POV videos that have been going on about Twisted Colossus, and you watch the ones at Wicked Cyclone, it looks like Wicked Cyclone, to me, would be more preferable. Now, maybe people don't like Wicked Cyclone, and Twisted Colossus would be the ride for you. But I really think that Wicked Cyclone's got this in the bag. I know I'm speaking too soon, and maybe I put my foot in my mouth, but I really think that Wicked Cyclone is going to take number one for 2015. I really do. I mean, after riding it, I was so excited. I'm like, there is no way that it can't win. When you look at all the rides that open this year, and you know what? If when it comes to the golden tickets, if you got in the top five for best new ride for best new ride for 2015, you're a winner. And you know why you're a winner? Because you put an attraction in your park and people are flocking to it. There's people that love the new Batman and Six Flags Fiesta Tech. They think it's fantastic. Same thing with Thunderbird. Same thing with Fury. Same thing with Wicked Cyclone and Twisted Colossus. Even, the Justice League Dark Rides. This year was definitely, it was one of those years that so many good rides came out that it's really anybody's ballgame. But I think at the end of the day, it's going to be between Wicked Cyclone and Twisted Colossus. I think at the end of the day, that's what your top, those are going to be one and two. I'm telling you, that's what my prediction is. That's what I think. And you know what? I could be wrong, but I'm going with my gut, and I'm calling it now. Wicked Cyclone wins number one for 2015. That's what I'm calling. I mean, some people, no, Fury was when I got off. I said this was, if I knew now what I knew then, before I went, I would have never went to Fury Media Day. The whole, it's a B&M, it's, B&M's are like the Rolls Royce of roller coasters. It's not going to be Fury. I'm telling you, it's not going to be Fury. The buzz between Wicked Cyclone and Twisted Colossus right at this moment is way higher than Fury and Thunderbird had all together. I think it's because, all right, if you go to the history of rides, the history of roller coasters, when B&M came out, they were the company you wanted to buy a roller coaster from. They were innovative, and they were just taking risks, and the risks paid off. Well, the new company to do that now is Rocky Mountain Coasters. Every single one of their coasters is a fan favorite. Maybe not, might not be number one, but that's the same thing with anything. But I don't see Fury taking number. I don't see it happening. I personally don't see Fury winning. I see Fury in the top five of new rides. I definitely see that. I think this is what I'm calling for the golden tickets for best of 2015. I'm calling Wicked Cyclone, Twisted Colossus, and Fury. That's going to be your top three right there. Then I'm going to go with, like, Thunderbird after that, and then maybe Justice League or Batman. You know, it's gonna be... That's going to be how it is. Because most people are not going to ride Cannibal. A lot of people are going to ride Cannibal. I don't know much about it. But a lot of people are going to ride Cannibal. But it doesn't have the power at this moment as Fury and Twisted Colossus and Wicked Cyclone. It just doesn't have that buzz. And I don't know if it's because it's so far out west that it's not really being talked about much out here. I barely hear anything about it, and I look at news feeds and everything. I've always been hearing the top three coasters that I heard about all the time was Fury, Twisted Colossus, Wicked Cyclone. That's all I saw everywhere. And that was from my friends out west, the Midwest, the South, the East. Those were the three coasters everybody's been talking about. Now, what's going to happen is the ones that are going to win are the ones that are going to keep the buzz going. Those are the ones that are going to have the legs to keep going until the ballot comes out. Because if they can't create the buzz, just word of mouth, that could help. But I think the buzz that the parks put out and the word of mouth, I think it's going to take those two elements to take the cake. And because Fury opened in March, that may have killed its chances. Now, I'm not saying Fury is a piece of crap at all. You know, I'm not saying that at all. For me, speed kills. Speed kills a ride. You don't see Top Thrill or King of Car in my top 10. You know, when I make my top 10, whatever, you know, this, that, and the other. Are they good rides? Yes, by all means. Yes, they are. Are they my favorites? No, they're not. Not at all. You know, the more I ride and the more I find different rides and stuff, for my opinion and what I want in a coaster that I want my most favorite, Wicked Cyclone delivers. Now, I don't know if you like coasters like I do. Maybe you don't like them like I do. But everything about Wicked Cyclone, for what I want, delivers everything that I want. It gives me everything. I mean, the Iron Reef looks interesting. You know, I love dark rides, so anytime a dark ride opens, I'm all for it. There's not enough of them in the world. There really isn't. I think more parks need to add dock rides. I think a dock ride should be mandatory in every park, whether it's a traditional or a shooting one, but every park needs one. And when you're speaking about Fury, it's this long track, right? And all it has is three airtime bumps. And it's got some cool little tricky trackies and that turnaround to go onto the tunnel. And it's got the first drop. If that's all you have in a long track, you wasted track. You could have done so much better with the track. And it doesn't give me everything I want. Me, I want that. I've spoken about that on this show so many times of what I like in a ride. And Fury does not deliver everything to make it my favorite ride. It just doesn't deliver it. I want tons of airtime. I want adjunct airtime. I want elements. And you know what? When Wicked Cyclone, when I said I wanted elements, it was almost like they stuck some kind of equipment on my head and said, "What do you want, Josh, for an elements? What do you want?" And it was like they served it on the platter and they put it and they made it. That is what I want. All the little, the reverse banks, over banks, airtime stalls and G-rolls and tricky tracky and everything, just all the little, you know, just going like that, crazy stuff. Wicked Cyclone delivers everything that I wanted. I have not seen a coaster on this planet deliver that. Like when I'm looking for the mecca of my, what I want to ride every time I go, the ride that I have to have, that is Wicked Cyclone. That is the ride. Because it delivers everything I want. It's not super fast. It's not super tall. But it gives me everything I want. And that's what it is. You know, it's... You know, I would love so much for Six Flags New England to get the dock ride. I want them to get the dock ride. I want the Justice League ride. They need to somehow get the town and the state to go, yeah, you can put one in. I know what all the fire safety is. I know. It's tough. But that's what they got to do. They have to put one in there. If they put that in there, you know, if they put one in there, forget it. It would be like my favorite. Well, it wouldn't be my favorite park in the world because it's like Knoebels. Knoebels is just the place to be at, you know, camping and the Woodies and all the old classic flats. But for locally, it would be my favorite park. I mean, it already is my favorite park locally, but I'm just saying it would be the place to go. They would have two world-class coasters. They would have a dark ride. They'd have some, you know, they'd have a bunch of coasters and some flats. And, you know, I go to Six Flags a lot. I'll be there Friday to Monday. I love Six Flags. I know a lot of people don't like it. I know a lot of people don't like Wicked Cyclone. They said too many inversions. Some people said they don't like it because they ripped it apart and they took it from Cyclone to Wicked Cyclone. And matter of fact, when I talked to Alan Schilke, I explained to him. I said, I've ridden Cyclone in every carnation that it's ever had. From different trains, to different drops, everything that they've done to that thing, I've ridden it. When they retracted, they put the top of track. Now, I know they did the top of track to it. I know that. And I told them, I said, from when they changed the drop and they put the top of track, I said, it killed the ride. I said, I said, maybe it was for the best that they did it because then we have this. And I, you know, and I was talking to him, telling him what I loved about the original Cyclone, what I hated happened to it. And then, but he did ask me, he goes, were you one of the ones that were pissed that when we were doing this? And I said, no. I told him, you know, exactly what I told him. I said, look, I said, I'm glad you guys did what you did. I said, we got something amazing. You know, because when he walked up the hill and I saw him, I walked up to him, I'm like, dude, you did an awesome job. Thanks for doing what you did. And then when I talked to him later, I mean, the guy's so awesome. If you ever see him, you know, he's very approachable, very nice guy. He's not a jerk. He's not, you know, self-centered, nothing like that. He's a great guy. And if you ask him questions, he'll give you the answer. He's not one of them shh kind of guys. I mean, he won't tell you future projects. We didn't even bother asking, you know, what's coming for 2000. You know, he can't talk about that. But anything up until that point, he'll tell you anything you want to know. The guy, you could tell the guy loves his job. You know, he's got the passion. He loves it. You know, all these coasters are like his little babies and stuff like that. It is awesome. Just to be able to talk to him. Plus, he's the guy who designed it, you know? So, it was definitely great. You know, some people are gonna love Wicked Cyclone. And Tony was like, he goes, I'm upset that, you know, I don't like it because it's, you know, it's all right. I don't like it because they ripped apart Cyclone. And then I, you know, when I sat with him and I was talking to him yesterday, I said, look, dude, I'm like, that coaster was dead. There was no ever bringing it back to the way it was. You would never, I said, you want it to run the way it was. And honestly, it ran like crap. He's like, oh, it ran good at closing. I'm like, yeah, one day of the whole year. I was like, dude, it was time to either rip it down and put something new or do what they did. And I prefer that they did what they did because Wicked Cyclone is amazing. And I can't wait for each and every one of you to ride it and then come and tell me what you've... you know, what you thought about it. Because if I see you at the park this weekend, please come up to me. I want to know what each and every one of you think about Wicked Cyclone. You know, it has nothing to do with, you know, I'm just anxious to see what people think about it. You know, I can't wait to see what the general public thinks about it. Wicked Cyclone is definitely a hit. If they've ever had one. This is probably the biggest thing that's happened to the park probably since Superman. This is probably the biggest thing ever. Well, anyways, we're going to get going. But before I do, I did say I am going to have a contest. And the contest is going to be, I'm going to post a video of the reverse POV. I'm going to nail it to the top of SFNE Online there. And what I want you to do is like it. I'm going to put the rules on it. Like it and share it. And then we will pick a winner. And I could tell you at least two of the items in the...
Yeah.
In the package is going to be one ticket to Six Flags Great Escape, which the ticket expires November 1st. So if you don't have a pass, or if you want to give it to a buddy. And then I'm also going to throw in a 2015 ticket to Six Flags New England that's valid from June 1st to June 30th to Six Flags New England into the pot. We have two tickets that we're throwing into the pot. I'm going to put the rules up after the show, and everybody who likes and shares it is going to win two tickets, plus whatever I decide to throw in the mix. It's only good for one person. It's not good for two people, but at least you can get, you know, either if you want to go to these parks, or if you got a season pass and you want to bring a buddy, then by all means, you can do that. So that's what that is. So anyway, we'll be back next Thursday. Same bat time. Same bat channel. Will I be? Yeah, okay. I will be. There's no like crazy trips going on next weekend. So I will be back Thursday, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And we'll probably talk some Wicked Cyclone and whatever else is going on. Probably some Twisted Colossus. I did not go to Diggerland, but Luco, Tony, and May did. Luco's working on the video of all the footage he took. We'll show that next week. So, Luco, if you're listening, you have to get the video done now. We'll see what happens next week as next week comes. Hopefully you enjoyed the show. Make sure if you want to win tickets, even still, just like, share the video anyway. Let's try and see if we can get a bajillion hits out of it, just to see if we can. Because before the show, it was almost at 1,500 views, which is crazy for me. I love it. But anyway, I will see all you guys next week. I'll see anybody at the park that shows up, and we can enjoy some Wicked Cyclone. So until next week, keep on coasting. Woo!